happen.
I believe we did.
Let's get this over with. Hello everyone, this is your good old neighbor Nick Hicks, Spider-Verse, and Frozen 2, and Cam, Possible Fans, as one, and I am really excited to do another SpongeBob review leading up to Saving Bikini Bottom, but not until I am doing a redo movie rant on the SpongeBob movie Sponge on the One. Let's get started, shall we? So hey guys, so the story for Sponge on the One, which honestly guys, I ain't gonna explain about it because you already know I am not a fan of telling you guys a story because honestly guys, if you want a more detail about the story, just look on your dictionary and look at Google and see it. Just use your common sense. Gotta give it to you, now use it. So hey guys, this film was originally gonna be released in theater the same as the SpongeBob SquarePants movie in 2004, and of course Sponge Out of the Water in 2015. But due to this film came out the worst timing, and this film got released in Canada due to a COVID-19 pandemic, which you already know what my thought on COVID-19 pandemic, which I don't want to talk about it because that's a one memory. I ain't going to talk about it. Cannot believe why it's been 4 years since that thing came out. For God's sake, Paul Parker, man. But I gotta say, I ain't going to mention that. The same thing with the movie called The Sea What? Yeah, I ain't going to say it. So you're not going to force me to. So yeah. Honestly, guys, in this film got released in Canada. And this film got released on Netflix on November. So honestly, guys, so we released this film. This film got released in Canada on August 14th, 2020. And after that, on digitally, Netflix in some countries, sadly not my area, but this film got released in some country on Netflix on November 5th, 2020. So the actual anniversary of the release in this film is going to get, honestly, this film is turning 4 years old, and typically this film came out in 2021, since Paramount Plus owned the right for this film, because this film is a Paramount movie, so of course, Paramount Plus have to add this film, so honestly guys, so yeah. Anyway guys, and I was really, not much anticipation for this film, praise to none. Honestly guys, I'm a fan of SpongeBob movie. The SpongeBob SquarePants movie is honestly one of my favorite movie of 2004. And Sponge Out of the Water, the most underrated movie of 2015, since Spectre and Pixel. But this film just didn't get me excited. The trailer just didn't seem interesting. And the story is just like the same old story from season 4. But honestly guys, and just like what Jane Possible said, you can't judge everything because it's cover. So cannot judge this film because the trailer, the same thing when I'm doing with the Saving Bikini Bottom. And yeah, sure, the Saving Bikini Bottom is not original. We see that type of story like a million freaking times. It's not original because what happened? That Paramount and Nickelodeon is not making original story. Yeah, that's what I thought. But honestly guys, and Paramount do some original story. Right, look at Top Gun Maverick, look at Scream 5 and 6, and look at The Wolf of Wall Street. Those films has the most genius story, and I'm sorry to say generic, because those films are not generic. Not gen- not generic as this. But honestly, guys, I was saying to myself, which rant should I do? Ghostbusters 2016 or SpongeBob 1? SpongeBob 1 or SpongeBob 1? Yup, I seriously thinking that people will really want me to do a rant on this film because they really like me to do raging on the SpongeBob thing. Well, I gotta say, but at least it's way better. At least this film is way better than One Course Meal, Yours, Mine, and Mine. Oh my god, that episode make me mad as heck. And even it's way better than the one episodes trying to be like Criminal Mind, just like SpongeBob falling in love with the Krabby Patty. Yeah, at least it's way better than that. And I don't want to say it anymore. But honestly, guys, is this my number one worst Nickelodeon movie? Nah, I don't want to go that far. But I'll put it on show. This film is in the close second. Don't get me wrong. This film is not the worst Nickelodeon movie ever. You already know what my worst Nickelodeon movie ever, which is other than this. And I don't want to say anymore. Sorry, guys. So at first, I watched this film in 2020. I watched this film on YouTube. But I gotta say, honestly, guys, my original opinion, I was like, it's good, but the SpongeBob SquarePants movie and even Sponge Out of the Water, which is a CGI hybrid SpongeBob movie, is even better than Sponge on One because this film was a major letdown, and I do like some good thing about this film, and I don't understand why I like the Kim Cola scene. Oh my god, I honestly hate that scene, but honestly, I don't want to talk about that scene, so that's the only scene I ain't gonna mention for this movie. So hey guys, and after we watch this film on DVD, I gotta say, it just got even worse every single time I rewatch this film. But don't worry, this film is not the worst movie from 2020. The worst film from 2020, which is another than the C word. Directed by Pedophile. Don't want to think about that freaking movie. Don't want to think about that. Honestly, guys, if you call this film as the worst movie of 2020, I am no idea. I am not a opinion basher, but I gotta say, but just get the freaking FBI in your house and work out your history. Yeah, honestly, guys. Oh my goodness, what is up with this? What is up with this today? Society that people is doing so many pedophile stuff. Hashtag protect your children. Protect your children, no matter what. No matter what the cost. No matter what the cost. Yeah. Honestly, guys, you wanna know what that quote from? It's from Audrey Studio, which is the Lego Batman series, which I do like to watch. Honestly, I would watch that instead of wasting my time doing one on this film. But, as sad as I had to say this, but I did not like this film. I now did not like this film at all. But I gotta say, but this is not the worst, this is hands down one of the worst Nickelodeon animated movies I ever seen for a very long time, says Boneyard. And I gotta say, but this film is the worst animated movie of 2020. This film made Troll World Tour look like a masterpiece over this. And don't get me wrong, I'm not a fan of Troll 2. At least that film has some fun scene of the time movie, like the ending, the jokes. I mean, some of the joke, I absolutely did not like some of the joke, right? Butt joke? Stop putting your butt joke in the kids' movie. That's stupid. Honestly, guys, and years ago they did that, but they keep doing that. Honestly, thanks to Patrick showing his butt cheek in the kids' movie back in 2004. I come the fake on, Patrick, you're not supposed to be doing that. It's a kids' movie. But, yeah, honestly, guys, it's a kids' movie. Kids should not be watching that. This is the type of film that you should not be watching. Yeah, honestly, I mean, to stop doing that. But honestly, guys, do I have any good thing about this film? Well, surprisingly, maybe, sort of. I do like the soundtrack in this film, like the SpongeBob soundtrack, Do Not Whip Me Down. I do like the Gary Come Home version of Kelsey G. It go. Man, I like Kelsey G. Kelsey G will not let us down, and I do agree with Squidward. And Squidward, no offense, you have too upset to Kelsey G. Kelsey G is a great position, but I gotta say, but he is not as best. Not as best as a Panic at the Disco. And you already know who it is. He's from the same artist that who sang one of the best Disney songs of 2019. Don't want to say ever, but I think Kim Possible theme song is a lot better. And even Another Believer is a lot better than E.T. Unknown. I like E.T. Unknown, but there's so many Disney songs I think it's a classic more than E.T. Unknown. Because I don't want to call E.T. Unknown the classic because it came out in 2010 decade. Because that's not a child right there. But honestly, guys, And when this film came out, this film got a mixed review. This film got a 66% on Rotten Tomatoes. And this film, oh God, that got me disappointing. This film got a 49%. Yep, even lower than Sponge Out of the Water. Really Nick Williams movie, really Paramount. It can show that you did not give a darn about this film right here. But once again, this film just got even worse every single time I rewatch this film. I'm very sorry. I'm scratching myself. Oh my goodness. Ow. 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 Sorry, guys. Anyway, I still have some good thing about this film. At least the soundtrack is the best part of the movie. And the climax is really entertaining. I absolutely left my butt off when Patrick was getting in the helmet. And all the guys in Plankton was in the Patrick butt. The second butt joke since 2004. It can show that Nickelodeon creator was so upsetting. Oh, so upsetting for his butt joke in the kids movie. Honestly, guys, and when Plankton saying, "You gotta be kidding me." Oh my goodness, that scene is so funny. So funny. At least some of the humor is really funny. I do meant that. And at least they have some emotion scene, like, even I did not like the villain, but when he cried, I actually feel bad for that character. And I do feel bad that he want everyone to remember him, honestly. And I do like the character who was a judge, a butler to the villain in the movie. Like Keen Poston, even I don't care about him, but I do feel bad for that character, by the way. But the last good thing I could give for this film, at least this film have one of the best things that Nickelodeon Paramount ever did, which is another thing giving a special tribute to the man himself, Steven Hillenburg. Even this film is have audacity to spin in the face of Steven Hillenburg, at least Nickelodeon movie. At least they put a memory to Steven Hillenburg. That is the best thing that Nickelodeon ever did. The rest of the movie, the biggest problem about this movie, which is other than the story. Have you never seen the season 4 of Have You Seen the Snail? That is way better than this. You know what? That's my thought on the story. The story is generic, cliche, and a typical SpongeBob movie. Like, yet again, another typical model SpongeBob thing that never stopped. And that's all I gotta say about the story. And the characters. Even I like some of the characters in the Thai movie, and I do like the cowboy character played by Daniel. He's a really great character, and he have to be one of the best characters in the Thai movie. At least his voice go, "Hey, stop at the party." Oh my goodness. And once again, in his death scene, which is other than SpongeBob and Patrick was blowing the sun on him and he died. Yeah, typical death scene for a kids movie, am I right? And honestly, guys, and that's the best character in the entire movie. The rest of the character was completely awful and horrendous. And I already talked about SpongeBob and Patrick and Ed O'Gain in this film. I mean, in the other review, which I did for the first movie and the sequel. If you want more detail about these two, I mean, these characters, just go in my review on the SpongeBob SquarePants movie and even SpongeBob movie Sponge Out of the Water. I already talked enough about them. Let's talk about the new character, which I forgot to mention in my last review. I mean, this review in general. Let's talk about Sage, played by the legendary Keon Wee. Keon Wee, what the heck are you doing this movie, man? No, you are John Wick, The Matrix, and even you are Duke Kaboom from Toy Story 4. But I gotta say, but this is the worst performance I have ever seen from Keon Wee. Oh my goodness, he was so dreadful in this film. Let's talk about Awkwafina. Oh, Awkwafina, no. Okay, first we got Keon Wee. Now we got Awkwafina. What is up for this film? Have some celebrity guests. We got Tiffany Haddish's. We got Smooth Dog. We got Awkwafina, and now we got Keon Wee. Oh my goodness, why is that American Got Talent. Oh, talent. Talent actor and actress is in a terrible movie like this. But I gotta say, but Awkwafina gave one of the worst robot voice I have ever heard from her. And for God's sake, her character in Kung Fu Panda 4, Way and the Last Dragon, the bad guy, and even Chun-Chi and the Legend of the Ten Rings is way better than her as a robot. All she say in this film, which is another than, you are fired. Shut up, you piece of crap. And thank goodness Mr. Crab just literally throw her into a garbage. Oh my goodness. Yeah, you got what you deserve. Anyway, guys, I do like Awkwafina. I do really do. I do like her in Winfield. I do like her in, I'm sorry, I do like her. I do like her and the bad guys. And do like her in Way and the Last Dragon. And speak of the bad guy, I might rewatch that film again and again and again. I would never get tired rewatching the bad guy. Which is my second favorite DreamWorks film of 2022, behind with the Puss in Boots, The Last Wish. But honestly. And anyway, and I do like Smooth Dog. I really do. But Smooth Dog get one of the worst cameo in this film. So let's hope his cameo in the Garfield movie as a cat is way better than his cameo in this film. But the only good thing about it, which is nothing, his song called How We Do, How We Do, How We Do. Man, that song is fantastic. I have no idea what the lyrics call, which I ain't gonna play it because I'm gonna get copyright again, just like my last review. But even I like some of the scene from that character, which I'm going to talk about, but the worst characters in this film, which is none other than the villain, Keen Postan. I have no idea what his name is, what I honestly don't give it on what his name is, and I have no bottle to work out my freaking research. Really? So, you give us King Neptune from the SpongeBob SquarePants movie, which is the best version of Keen. But King Postan, he is King Neptune done bad. But I gotta say, but this is the worst villain of 2020. And honestly, I do admit, the scene which he was crying, at least I feel bad for that character. And that is hands down one of my favorite scenes from the bad film, honestly. Because I do feel bad for that character. But that doesn't mean he's the greatest villain. But honestly, you do know what his villain plan is? Which is another thing, grabbing a 100 snail and rub it all over his face like a freaking lotion. It was really, really, really uncomfortable, guys. Because that scene, I don't want to talk about it. You know what? That's what I'm going to get. That's what I'm going to get right here. But honestly, guys, I do like the scene when he was crying. I do feel bad for that character. But that villain plan, when he was grabbing the 100 snails and rub it all over his face like a freaking lotion, that is the worst villain plan I ever seen since a villain from the Wild. Yeah, that is even better than that, honestly. You know what? I don't want to go that far to saying this because the villain from the Wild is way worse than the villain in this film. Don't worry, I'm not going to compare it to those because they both have nothing to comment, honestly. And at least the voice acting is not that bad, honestly. It's not half-assed, honestly, guys. And I'm very sorry to say the A word, so my apology. And at least the casino scene was really entertaining. But honestly, guys, I'm part of this film will not get a 2 out of 10, but I'm pretty darn sure this film deserves even a garbage, so yeah. Anyway, guys, in the ending was really just a random ending, which is other than SpongeBob and his friend cheer up with King Postan, and after he got rid of his niceness, and he worked honestly one of the most ugliest looking king I ever seen. I gotta say, but King Neptune from the SpongeBob SquarePants movie, the same actor that he was in the Troll movie, and How the Grinch Stole Christmas, which is 2000, no, I'm not talking about the 2018. No, he was not in that one. No, I'm talking about the 2000 one, the good one, not the mediocre one. I'm talking about the good one, I'm not talking about the Illumination one, I'm talking about the one from Jim Carrey one. So, you already know what I'm talking about, I ain't gonna say it. And sorry, you guys, and at least this film has seen an emotional moment, but that's it. The rest of the film was completely stupid. Honestly, guys, the ending was kind of random. Honestly, I don't want to talk about how ugly that king is, which I ain't gonna talk about, so we'll skip it. Anyway, guys, the ending, which is another than SpongeBob is feel sad yet again, and Gil, sorry, no, he did not do that in the movie. I'm sorry, at the end of the movie, man, I am so stupid. Anyway, there was an ending in the movie when SpongeBob is feel happy that Gary is back, and blah blah blah, and SpongeBob cooking Krabby Patty, give it to Gary in his mouth, and Gary spit at it, and give it to the other snail, and spit it out to the customer. Ew, no one wants to taste that. Nobody wants to taste that. What's your feet band? What's your feet band? Nobody eat that. Sorry. And all the guys, and there was one scene when Gooey spit the Krabby Patty and give it to Gooey. I mean, and give it to the other snail, and the other snail, give it to the customer. Ew, that is disgusting. I gotta say, but where was your feet band? Where was your feet band? I'm sorry, but nobody wants to eat that kind of Krabby Patty. That is disgusting. My cheeseburger is way better than that disgusting Krabby Patty. And even Big Mac is way better than the Krabby Patty in, this film, honestly. And honestly, guys, there was an ending when they played a music called... What's that song called again? Oh, it's Snail of a Life. And that clam go... And when they show the bikini bottom... And break out, the movie's over. And until they showed the memory of Steven Hillenburg, and it was really touching. I will miss you, Steven Hillenburg. I will miss you so much. So overall, guys, the SpongeBob movie, Sponge on the One. Even I have good thing about this film, but I might be too nice. At least this film is not as bad as Artemis Fowl and even The Sea World that directed by a pedophile. But I gotta say, but this film is honestly one of the top 10 worst movie of 2020. The story is generic. The character is all... ruin, especially honestly, except the cowboy character and even some of the scene that I have to do with King Poston. At least King Poston tried his best for this performance. Honestly, guys, it's from the same director that who give a critic acclaim movie, which is better than Hop, the one grandpa movie, which came out the same year as this film, starring Robert De Niro, and of course The Garfield Movie 2. Yay. Yeah, this film was really spit in the face when you brought a director for Hop. Honestly, I totally understand why that director was a actual producer for the SpongeBob Movie 1. But it's for the best that you could just stick to that instead of directing this film, honestly. Because this film has nothing to do with Steven Hillenburg. Because this is literally a Nickelodeon movie cut. Because Nickelodeon movie would not do this such a stuff like this. Because that's the end of my movie. I'm sorry. Honestly, guys, I will get to that in a minute. Sorry, guys. This film is honestly one of the worst animated movies of 2020. And I would watch Scoob way better than watching this piece of SpongeBob crap, I meant to say. Even this film has some good things, but at least, honestly, those good things did not save this film at all to give this film like a 2 out of 10. But honestly, I don't want to give this film like a 1 out of 10, a 2 out of 10, because I just want to be nice with SpongeBob. Today is the 20—honestly, it's been 25 years since SpongeBob came along, and I'm getting fan of SpongeBob. So, I might be nice for this film, but even this film going to get a zero naked garbage, but I might be nice for this film, by the way. Honestly, I forgot to talk about the animation. Yeah, the animation's stupid. Yeah, the animation's disgusting. It's stupid. It's the worst looking out of the SpongeBob movie. And I do not want to talk about the face suppression that what the character did. Especially to have the one scene when Plankton go, whoa, what's this stupid face suppression? Honestly, guys, let's get the waiting before I cringe so hard just like I'm in the stupid face suppression. But in a bad way, impossible. Sorry, guys. What rating should I give this film? Okay, what rating should I give this horrendous film right there? But I get a sad, but I'm probably the same. No. Let's not do that. That's copyright. Oh, okay. What rating should I give this film? Okay. Here we go. I'm going to give the SpongeBob movie, Sponge on the One, a 3 out of 10. Is a really, really bad movie. But even this film has some good things about it, but those good things did not save this film to give this film like a 3 out of 10. It's a freaking 3 out of 10. So screw it. And this film deserves a seal of Nick Hicks garbage. But I gotta say, but this film is way better than the movie from 2010 directed by M. Night Shyamalan Ding Dong. And I did not show a picture of that earlier, so I ain't gonna show a picture again. So don't worry, you won't remind me about that film. Honestly, it's kind of remind me of the song called Remind Me. Remind me, remind me. Okay, that was a terrible scene, so I'm very sorry. So like, Carrie Underwood done bad. Sorry, guys, that was my Ouija movie rant to one of the worst SpongeBob movie ever, which is better than the SpongeBob movie, Sponge on the One. Tell me about your opinion on this film. If you're a defender of the movie, that's fine. But I'm seriously thinking, but even I did not like this film, I gotta say right now, but I'm part of this film is getting too much hate, which even I didn't care about that film, because I'm part of this film is getting, sorry, it's giving me the same reaction like Despicable Me 4. Yeah, honestly, I might now give that film like a 3 out of 10. So now Despicable Me 4 is now a 3 out of 10 movie. The same thing with this. Because this film is getting the same rating just like my Despicable Me 4. So Despicable Me 4 and SpongeBob 1 are both getting a 3 out of 10. So it's 3 out of 10. So it's good. Anyway, guys, so tell me about your opinion on this film on the comments in your book. Think it's good, think it's bad, think it's mediocre, think it's a letdown, think it's disappointing, think it's a worse. Comment below. And let me know in my last video for the night, which is another than my thought of Inside Out 2, beat the Mario, beat the Super Mario Bros. Movie at the box office. Let's go! Yeah, not let's go, because joy, sadness, anger, fear, disgust, and even anxiety, and all the emotion character, and even rally, beat the Mario movie at the box office. Yeah, honestly, they literally beat Princess Peach. Yeah, part of the Illumination fan base is not going to be happy, and they refuse to watch Inside Out 2. Even I think Illumination is a mediocre, but I gotta say, but honestly, I have to end this video right now before my mom called me. Anyway, this is Nick Hicks, Spider-Verse, and Frozen 2, and Kim Puzzle Fan 2001, signing out, and stay tuned for my next video, which is tonight. Goodbye, everyone. See you guys next time.